operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part. You can't even passively take part. And you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop.
The Dean Blundell Show. 102.1. Yes.
This is your Edge.
Got it. Hold it.
Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
Jonathan Brink, 27-year-old, arrested on the weekend after fighting with police following a drunken quest for sex from his neighbor's wife. That always goes good, doesn't it?
Let me have sex with your wife.
That's what he did. He went next door. He started banging on the door of his neighbor's house. He didn't even know his neighbors. Yeah, he's like,
let me have sex with your wife.
The guy's like, get out of here, man. He's like,
she's hot. I watched her garden the other day. I want to hit it. I want to tap that ass. I want to have it.
Who gets that drunk?
Jonathan Brink.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Cops arrived, found him super wasted, intoxicated, and violent, and then he said to a female officer,
hey, let's you and me have some sex. Come let's on. Have some sex, all right.
That never works, eh? It doesn't matter what you
well,
do.
Well, I don't know. It's the odd time. But well, maybe. It's usually somebody you don't want to have sex with.
And it's usually just you that it works for.
No, I'm talking about like in a bigger girl.
Oh, like, oh, yeah, that'll work.
Let me have sex.
Okay.
I didn't mean to ask you.
Yeah, Tubby. Not you. Him.
Meet Tim Paez. He was arrested at Shooter's Bar and Grill. What's up, Shooter?
Mm.
After whizzing on a woman who said no to his advances, apparently walked up to her just before midnight, put his arm around her. He's like, can I buy you a drink? Please. Woman's like,
no, thank you.
She's like, okay, whatever. You didn't know what you missed, honey. That's when Tim walked away, came back, and the woman said she turned around after she felt a wet substance on her leg.
Oh, no. He did like under the bar kind of move?
Yeah, it was body temperature urine is what it was. That was the warm substance. And he sat and emptied his bladder on her. That's when he zipped up his pants, highly intoxicated, walked out of the bar only to be tased by police.
Whoa!
Later admitted, yeah, I remember taking a leak. I don't remember where.
Yeah, sure you don't. Sure, buddy.
I gotta tell you, I don't have a clue where I peed.
Oh, it was on a woman.
Oh, man, I'm sorry.
The guy says, wasn't good enough. He's in jail. It's never good to do that.
I love these drunk stories.
I've been so drunk before. We all have. Back
yes.
In, everybody's been. I have never once whizzed on someone while I was wasted because they turned me down. I've never flashed anybody. I've never gone next door to my neighbors. These are two good drunken stories.
Yeah.
I've never gone to my neighbor's house and gone,
hey, I want to have sex with your wife.
Yeah, maybe if she was hotter, I would have.
Your neighbor? Ugly neighbors, yeah. Eh? That's the problem. Yeah.
And Mayor Ford has admitted himself to the hospital.
Oh,
Rob
no.
Tubby Ford, the 330-pound Toronto mayor, after he said he felt unwell. His press secretary said, quote,
well, earlier this evening, Mayor Rob Ford admitted himself to the hospital after feeling unwell. The mayor is currently under observation as a precautionary measure and is expected to make a full recovery.
His press secretary, George Christopoulos, said in a statement emailed to media just before midnight, the mayor had to undergo a procedure to break up a kidney stone. It was very painful. I'm glad it's out. That was back in 2011.
Oh, okay.
It's very painful. I'm glad it's out. A lot of guys said that after pride, too. Also had surgery 10 years earlier for a kidney stone. In 2009, when he was a city councilor, he went to the hospital with excruciating pain, had a tumor removed from his appendix, later turned out just to be three grilled cheese taped together.
They're just stuck.
Well, that's not a tumor. That's a Wimpy's burger.
Well, that's seven patties attached to it. You're not supposed to do that. I mean, maybe a double. Each of them had cheese, too.
Yeah.
Each one. That's seven slices of cheese.
Maybe he just had poutine growing in his stomach.
Oh.
You know, the funny part is I heard this morning, I was driving in, and I laughed. They're like, they do one of these. The mayor has been admitted to hospital with a stomach ailment. And I was like, no.
Go figure that one out.
Get out of here.
You really?
Yo, get out of here.
I like the way they say he's expected to make a full recovery.
Oh, he'd be full, yeah, all right. Yeah. It's your edge files, whatever the hell day it is. In the, wow, who'd have saw that coming?
Yeah, really.
Stomach problems. Those are your edge files, whatever the hell day it is in August, year 2012.
The Edge Files.
On 102.1.
The Edge.
Edge.
The Dean Blundell Show.
I have some bad things to say about those people.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Friggin', I heard it. Flying through my friggin' damn wall.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Boom, man.
102.1.
Friggin', I knew it.
The Edge.
Talking about the Olympics earlier and how the most of the Olympians, and I don't mean just from Canada. There's some very obscure, strange sports that seem more like hobbies in the Olympics. And this morning Canada got two more medals. Very proud. Adam Vancouver and Mark Aldershot. I believe they're both Ontario kids. Members of the canoe and kayak club just down the road here. And Drughead even started laughing when I started about talking, when I said the words canoe and kayak club. Our producer, he's like, canoe and kayak club sounds geeky. Anyway, we were discussing this earlier, and I thought, you know, it seems to me most of the sports that we excel in, or even that are in the Olympics, generally speaking, are sports that people probably were forced into because they were bad at the mainstream sports.
Like hockey, football, baseball.
Basketball. Yeah. And because
I agree.
It's like when you meet someone and you say, hey, what do you do for a living? He goes, oh, I'm a professional mime. And you go, well, how the hell did you get into that? Like, how did someone get into canoeing?
Yeah, canoeing like could be just a hobby, obviously, on a cottage or something. But I mean, if you take it seriously, I agree with you. I think that at some point you weren't good enough for the high school like hockey team.
Yeah. So like the dad says, even considered kayak. So
I saw the way you avoided the hit and good hand. You want to do fencing?
Yeah. You're terrible at lacrosse. Why don't you try fencing? You're really bad at lacrosse. How about badminton? And I like badminton. But it just seems to me like those are the... Because, you know, and what sports aren't in the Olympics that we talked about earlier that would be great to see? You know, like a baseball's not in the Olympics anymore.
I'm shocked rugby isn't in it, to be honest.
You know what I was watching the other day? Women's water polo. I'm like, you got to be kidding me.
Oh, I saw that, too. I saw that.
These are all women that didn't make the swim team.
I mean, and Grant, we're not saying it doesn't take a lot of athletic ability to do this stuff.
Oh, this take the women's water polo is like it was awesome to watch though.
Yeah,
like it was like a gladiator match. They beat the crap out of each other.
But they got cut from softball
big time.
Yeah.
It's true.
Do you see
I checked. I talked to some Olympians, and most of them were like, "Yeah, we were really bad at normal sports, so we had to do the weird ones." And that's what the Olympics are for. People that are bad at normal sports get to do the Olympics.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's not awesome. Like this guy,
We couldn't do it.
Great story out of, I think, Hamilton or something. I don't know, Ontario somewhere. The guy that won bronze in the high jump yesterday, Darren Druin. Never even been in the world championships. Just got all kinds of natural ability. And he went to the Olympics and won a bronze. Like, that's cool. But, you know, when you go home and you talk to your buddies that work at, I don't know, Nesbitt Burns. Or they play professional hockey, you know? Do you go, hey, this is my buddy Mark. He's a high jumper,
like Taekwondo. Like I know it's cool, but it's like you can do that in like you know in the little plaza down the road,
big
like,
time. Yeah, you can do it in the backyard. Do it anywhere. Ping pong once again, ridiculous. I probably could have medaled at ping pong.
Have you seen these synchronized swimmers?
No,
they are freaky looking. Not really on topic, but I think it's just one of those. They put them in clown outfits.
Oh, do they?
Because they do all makeup because it's all facial expressions.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And then they clog their nose and they look like Chucky.
It's totally true.
You don't see that in other sports.
No, you don't see women before they play a hockey game. You don't see them getting all dolled up with their hair slicked back and smiling the whole time because they get points for looking good too. You shouldn't in sports. You shouldn't get points for looking sweet.
That is well said.
I'm just saying. The women's mascara didn't run. That's two more points. What a sport. It's ridiculous.
A lot of them are leisure activities, like sailing.
Yeah,
like,
ridiculous. Yeah. My favorite was windsurfing. Yeah, they saw that they had windsurfing in the Olympics. I'm like, anything you do on vacation to get away from your life is not an Olympic sport.
The Dean Blundell Show. Oh, ah! Mornings on the Edge.
This was sent to us by Mike. He said, hey, guys, did you see the three fellas? It was a news story, right?
Yeah, it's just sort of a video.
Talking about a video of these three guys talking about a local fire, if you haven't heard it. This is awesome.
Okay,
here we go.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God,
the
no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's full... No, it's this place.
Isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday's.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
Man, that's yesterday's. I was freaking out because I was like...
Oh, my God. And it's raining. And it's raining.
Get some pictures.
Get some pictures. Is that it?
Yeah, that's
all it is, yeah. Eh? Get some pictures. Listen to these guys.
Dude, yeah.
They're talking about this fire. It is crazy.
They're driving by a fire and they're videotaping on their phone, I guess.
Oh my god.
Listen to, I know.
This is serious.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no,
girl.
That's yesterday's.
Oh, my God,
the bar and grill.
The bar.
It's full... No, it's this place.
Isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday's.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
Man, that's yesterday's. I was freaking out because I was like...
Oh, my God. And it's raining. And it's raining.
Get some pictures.
I don't know why I find that so funny.
Yeah, one more time. You gotta play one more time.
Listen, girl.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God, no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's full... It's this place.
Isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday's.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
Man, that's yesterday's. I was freaking out because I was like...
There we go.
Oh, my God. And it's raining. And it's raining.
Get some pictures. I don't know why it's still so funny.
I love the way it starts off.
Girl.
The Loobies is on fire.
The Loobies.
I don't know what
it's called. Loobies?
It's something like that.
The Loobies
that.
Is on fire.
What does he say?
I don't know. It's the Loobies.
The Loobies is on fire.
Sounds like he's talking about his nipples.
These Loobies are on fire. Big time. They've been squeezed like crazy.
Oh, my God.
One more time.
The way it starts off.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God, no.
The bar and grill. Yes.
The bar.
It's this place.
Isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday's.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
Man, that's yesterday's. I was freaking out because I was like...
Oh, my God.
Get some pictures.
And it's raining. And it's raining.
Get some pictures.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks, Mike, for the video.
It's awesome.
Hi, The Edge.
Oh, my God.
Hey, who's this?
It's Larry.
What's up, Larry?
Not much, man. That's too much. Those guys looking at the fire.
Serious.
I had a question, though, dude.
It's raining.
Casby Awards. I heard about the ad yesterday. Wicked lineup coming up. How do I get my hands on some tickets, man?
You get your hot roasted tickets
right here. I think you can only get them to win them right now, but I think they go on sale. No, they don't go on sale. They're just a winner. We're giving them all away. So be listening. No, we're gonna. It's like a month and a half away. We'll give away 1 million pairs of tickets. So don't worry about it.
All right, man. Well, yeah. I guess I'll try back with something else later on.
All right, brother. I'm serious. So hot.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh my god, no, that's yesterday's.
The Loobies is on fire. I could just play that one clip all day. All day. Listen. It was awesome.
The Loobies is on fire.
Yes, it is. At the Edge.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
I'm just want to say welcome back.
It's, thanks, bud.
The stuff is great, but it's just not the same.
Thank what do you mean? Oh, the best stuff is great. I thought you said the new stuff is great, but it's not the same.
We'd rather you not there.
It was good, now it's worse.
Yeah.
The Loobies is on fire. At the Edge.
Hey, good to have you guys back.
Thanks, brother. What's your name?
Ryan.
Hey, Ryan, what's up?
Not much. I know it's a little dated now, but I just finally saw that Keys to VIP with Todd. Yep. Oh, man, he's jokes. He even got the free Budweiser hat on to kill it and everything.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, he really did a good job.
Thanks,
yeah,
bud.
Yeah, that was like 7 years ago he did Keys to the VIP. Wasn't the guy, one of the guys in it, wasn't he a massive douche?
Oh, the biggest douche in the city.
Which one was
he? Yeah, yeah. Well, I don't have to say. Okay. Don't worry. It's just a massive edge. Douche.
Hey, can you play that train clip again?
Oh, oh, the guy just too. Going eight oh, balloons man. Over the train?
Yes. Yeah, man.
They call them foamers. We did that yesterday.
Yeah, that's great.
I want to hear that again. Yeah. Man.
All right.
I had a buddy call me up last night and say that was like the funniest thing he ever heard.
The guy going nuts with the train? Yeah. It was bizarre. This guy, these guys are called foamers. This guy's waiting for a heritage train. Oh, my God. The Loobies is on fire.
Okay. Ah, I've been waiting for this moment for months, and it's finally here. I'm finally going to get a heritage unit on camera. Yeah! All right. Look at that, a 1953 E8. Woo-hoo! Oh, yeah, listen to that bell. Yeah, listen to that bell. Oh, take a look at that. Oh, my God! Woo!
The Loobies is on fire.
Hey, the Edge.
Oh, hi, Todd. I was just thinking you guys totally have to make like a song of that. I'm killing myself laughing at those guys from the video, and you got to chop it up and make like a song out of the Loobies. The Loobies is on fire.
The Loobies is on fire. Here, listen to this.
The Loobies is on fire.
Listen to the rest of it, though. This is what gets me.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God, no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's, no, it's this...
Oh, I can hardly drive.
Is that yesterday's?
Oh, jeez, yeah. Yeah, no, maybe we will.
Well, welcome back, guys.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. Have a great day. Hey, the Edge. Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Hey.
Yeah. I was on hold for like 20 minutes. I got cut off there. Oh. I was talking about the Olympics.
Yeah, I don't think we want to talk about it right now. Don't talk about the Loobies being on fire.
The Loobies is on fire.
Hi, the Edge. Hey, see you later. Hi, the Edge.
All right, what are the calls you're taking for now?
Open phones.
Is it okay to tell the story?
Yeah, sure.
You want the story?
Yeah, he said, yeah, sure.
Working HVAC. Old Indian guy in Brampton grabbed my junk.
Get out of here.
I'm not kidding.
Are you serious? You just walked up and grabbed your package?
No. We were down in the basement showing him everything on the furnace, and he decided to grab it.
What do you mean he decided to grab it? He just grabbed your...
He just put his hand on my junk.
Was he smiling at you when he did it? Was he mad at you?
He had a nice smile on his face.
I've never had my package grabbed by a guy. But I can imagine it'd be probably one of the more disconcerting things to happen, especially when you're on the job.
Well, I looked at him and I said, how did you know?
No way. Are you serious?
I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
That would have been mint. If you'd have done that, you'd have been one of my heroes.
Did I tell you about my what happened with someone grabbed my nipples recently?
Why? No.
Did I didn't tell you this story? I thought I told you this story. A guy
grabbed your nipples?
So I was at it was just like a patio. It was late at night.
Yeah. I think I know who it might have been.
The Loobies is on fire.
Might have been that guy.
So I'm like, I'm just talking to some friends, and all of a sudden, like, someone reaches around and, like, starts playing with my nipples. And, like, for a second, I'm like, oh, it feels pretty good. And then I turn around, and I'm not even lying. It's this massive black guy.
And he grabbed your nipples?
And he's like, you're so sexy. And I'm not, and he goes, you're so sexy. Look at you. And I'm like, what are you doing, man? I didn't know. You're just sexy. So I was kind of flattered, right? I'm like, But then, real quick, so then about 10
but
minutes.
But are you flattered or are you scared? Well, there's two different opinions. Because you get, like, if a gay guy accosts you and you're not gay, two things that will go through in my mind. A, shoot me. B, please don't let this fella be one of the aggressive ones.
Well, he seemed like, you know, he would have been. But the crazy part is about 10 minutes later, I ran into an old friend. Actually, the guy's name is Todd as well. And he goes, we're just talking, and he goes, hey, you see that guy over there? I go, yeah. He goes, careful, he grabs people's nipples. So I wasn't even... He was touching my nipples earlier, he tells me. So I wasn't even like he liked me. He just was doing it to everyone.
Oh, well, then you didn't feel special.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
That's, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Especially because there's some movement there. Yeah. So I was like...
Hi, The Edge.
Yeah, I'm calling for open phone.
What's up?
I'm Max, man. How are you doing?
Good. What do you need?
I was just wondering if Dean was going to let the girls drive topless this summer.
What do you mean?
Well, last summer he told all the girls to drive
always, topless. Yeah. Always women should drive topless. There's no point in wearing a top when you're in the car. I said it 1,000 times. Don't wear a shirt when you're in the car, girls. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, I'm kind of happy that the professional players don't play in the Olympics.
Are you?
Yeah.
Well, they do in tennis.
Yeah, they do in tennis. They do in hockey. I think they did in baseball, too, but they got their asses handed to them. Yeah. Basketball they do, which has just been a joke. Although I'm really looking forward to the race walk final later.
Well, that's what we were saying earlier. Could you take a professional athlete and just throw them in one of these sports and see how they were to do?
Yeah, like a professional athlete that does another sport.
Yeah, like I bet like a super in-shape NFL wide receiver. I bet you would be just a great rower.
Oh, sure.
I guarantee you.
Yep.
Like, I guarantee you put, like, four great athletes in a what are the boats? Rowing boats?
I couldn't tell you.
And like train them for a week. I bet you they'd finish top three. I guarantee you.
I might finish top three. I'd be winded as like crazy. Yeah. Can you smoke in the Olympics?
That'd be hilarious. Yeah. You're on the
with
boat.
With a Colt? With a cigarillo in my mouth?
Hurry, hurry. Go.
Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
Hey.
Dean, yeah. It's me from yesterday, the singing landscaper.
Hey, dude.
Hey, I just wanted to apologize for yesterday because I was so in shock that I got on the air that I forgot to sing to Todd and Derek.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
All right. Baby, you light up my world like nobody else. The way that you flip your hair gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile at the guy, it's hard to tell. You don't know. Oh, you don't know you're beautiful.
That one's for you, Todd and Derek.
All right.
For what happened, you can call back at 9. That was good, though, dude. Thanks.
Loobies is on fire.
Dude, anytime we suspect someone maybe might under suspicion of, you know, like, oh, he might be. He might be. Loobies is on fire. You know what he might be?
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God,
the
no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's it's this place.
Isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
The Dean Blundell Show on The Edge. Jill, line 3, good morning.
Good morning.
What's your question?
Okay, husbands who delete text messages with girls from work.
You don't say.
Well, Here's my theory. He's getting ready to buy you something really nice, so he doesn't want you to find out.
How about no?
Are you suspicious that he's having an affair?
Possibly. He doesn't seem like the affair type.
No one does.
It's just really weird. And it's inappropriate conversations with a girl that's about 10 years younger.
Oh, has he been having them?
He is having them, and he got caught with his hand in the cookie jar sort of thing, so.
Well, just the conversations, or did he bone her, too?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
Well, let me just say this. Sometimes some dudes just need to accomplish the chase, and then knowing that the woman likes him back.
Right.
I will say that. So maybe he's just worried. Maybe he is doing the heavy flirting, and there is some sort of affirmation there that she likes him, but he's not acting on it, or he could be just a total pig.
Okay. I choose total pig, but okay.
Well, that how long have you been married to him?
5 years.
Kids?
Yeah, 2.
Do you have any other examples other than him text? Like, what kind of inappropriate text? Like, I can't wait to bleep your bleep and...
No, not that bad. He's just extremely flirtatious with girls. Mm-hmm. And these girls are skankwads. I don't know if I can say that, but they're...
What's
they're
a skankwad?
Well, they're just dirt balls. You know, they're let's just say their standards aren't exactly very high.
What does that say if they like your husband?
This is what I'm saying.
Are you good looking?
I'd say 7 or 8. I don't know.
Yeah, you sound cool. You can tell when you talk to a girl if she's cool or hot or both.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just,
it comes
weird.
Down to this. Do you have a good relationship with him?
Yeah, for the most part. I mean, everybody's got bumps in the road, right? But we work through it.
Okay, so did you ever cheat on him?
Never.
And you're the only thing that you're wondering is if he's actually doing something and why he's deleting texts. So now if you go back to the history of what you've been through with him, you've already caught him once and now he's deleting text and hiding things. So I'm thinking he's probably not looking for that perfect Christmas gift.
Agreed. It just seems suspicious to me because I confronted him on the whole situation and then he goes, he doesn't understand why some of the text messages are sent, right? So I'm like,
I love listening to you.
Who the hell is going to know, right?
Yeah.
Seriously.
No, I know. Listen, with him telling you that you're crazy or him telling you that there's something wrong with you because you're upset with him, the best defense is a good offense. So he's A, hiding something, and I don't want to out the guy because if he is hiding something, he's unhappy. You might as well just not be there.
Right.
But
see, that's the other thing is I don't understand why he would be unhappy, right?
Like, how many times a week do you guys do it?
2 or 3.
Is it good?
It's good when it happens. Yeah. Absolutely.
Do you, every time?
What the reason? I mean, I could understand if I was a total prude and there was absolutely nothing going on, right?
Some guys just can't have enough.
Yeah.
Oh.
Some guys just can't have enough because it's
so
newer.
It's different.
Right.
Maybe you got to, it's time maybe to inspect the wiener.
Yeah,
that's always the telltale sign of a cheater.
Does he? You still have sex with him 2-3 times a week, even though you think he's doing something inappropriate?
Well, I just realized this, so it hasn't happened since I realized it.
The sex, you mean?
Sex hasn't happened since I've figured this out.
Uh-huh.
But that's just because it's been a little tense, obviously, right?
Oh, or he's cheating on you.
I gotta be honest. Yeah. I'm ready to cheat on her.
He's
I'm
cheating
joking.
On
I'm
you.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would have that honest conversation with him and say, hey, dude, if you're out there and the Loobies is on fire, get out there. Hi, The Edge. Amy.
Hi.
Hey, how are you? Good, how are you?
I'm okay.
What's up?
I wanted to know, why is it that it's so difficult for guys, or maybe just my man, to apologize when he's done something wrong?
Because saying sorry is for pussies. I said that on Twitter this morning.
Oh, really?
Yeah, unless it gets you some sex and it's all good.
Okay.
Well, what has he done wrong recently?
No, it's nothing too dramatic. It's just, when I'm upset or whatnot. It just,
well, some guys don't think that they're wrong, though. This is what makes me laugh. Is he might not think he's wrong, so he doesn't need to apologize. But what I've realized during my second go-around, and I said this to my girlfriend a long time ago, I'm like, there's really no right or wrong anymore. It's just personal preference. So if you don't like what I say sometimes, that's your personal preference. And if I don't have to say it, then I won't say it. But, you know, if you're looking for an apology for something that some guy didn't do wrong or in his eyes, you're never going to get one. And there's no point in holding out for it.
And let's be honest, he probably wasn't wrong.
And you deserve it.
I'll admit it when he's right. That's for sure. I'll admit it.
Well, that's cool. You know what? Accountability is the best thing that you can have in a relationship. But
if he doesn't think he's wrong,
it's just his deal. Yeah.
Yeah, same thing with women. If you guys don't think you're wrong, I'm not going to wait. I'm going to wait for an apology because I believe I was wrong. Well, it's a matter of opinion. And if it's not a big deal, forget about it. So many marriages are destroyed by waiting for a sorry.
Yeah, true enough. Well, this is awful because I'm sure he's listening right now, too, and now he's just got another one in there.
Forget it. You just ask why you can't. Yeah. Now you've
or just have some sex tonight. And
just put it in your hand.
Yeah.
Grab it later and put it in your hand a bunch of times. It'll be
fine. Put the shawarma in the pita.
Yeah. Put the Loobie on fire. Yeah.
It's on fire.
The Loobie is on fire. Brianne.
Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Good. Okay, so on the weekend, I was watching the men's speed walking race.
How exciting was that?
Well, the only reason I watched it is because the guy in green from Ireland, he looked like he was freebagging it. So everything was like swinging right to left, slapping it. So I'm wondering how that would have been comfortable.
Sometimes it's better not to constrict them.
But in a speed walking race, I mean, they're pretty fast.
Let's be honest. Speed walking isn't that fast.
No, it was true.
Usain Bolt is fast.
That's speed running. That's very fast. I can't do anything without Get Sean, so I'm the last guy to ask. I mean it. Like I gotta wear. You know these underwear that these guys make. They're called My Package. Have you seen these? What they do is there's this. You should. There's this thing where you put your whole package in this pouch in the front, and it basically cradles it for the whole day. Plus, it amplifies what you're doing down there. It's like a crazy natural way to put your stuff away from the rest of your body. And there's another one called Sax. Have you heard of that?
No.
These are
really
great too. SAXX.
Do they make that part an extra large?
Yeah. Okay. Just for me. Made to order. I couldn't do it. Do you watch those guys run the 100 meters? No one's wearing underpants.
Yeah, I don't know. I have trouble.
Usain Bolt 6'5". It leaves nothing to the imagination. That's a hammer.
I was going
to
say, I have trouble sea-doing in a bathing suit.
Yeah. I have trouble sitting, walking, because and standing.
It's like that impact.
Yeah.
Freaking kills.
By the edge. Stephanie.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. What's up?
Nothing. So I got a question for the uncircumcised folk out there. Mm-hmm.
Ew.
When you, I know. When you guys go tanning, do you, because I guess you kind of have an option here, do you guys pull it back or do you leave it up?
Well, First of all, you're assuming that we're circumcised. We're not circumcised.
Yeah. And who tans naked?
Everyone tans naked.
Not where I tanned, because I was at the cottage with my dad.
And they both don't have foreskins. They're incredibly Jewish.
A tanning bed.
No, first of all, there's a big problem. If you are a man and if you go to a tanning bed, you are instantly a moron.
Mm-hmm.
There is no excuse for a guy to go to a tanning bed. There is zero. For you to fake how you look halfway through the year just to get it all up in the spring and the fall and the summer, forget it. You're an idiot. The second thing is, if you're not circumcised and you're tanning, you deserve to never, ever, ever, ever interact with human beings. You deserve to be punched square in the face. So, uncircumcised.
Which is why I've never dealt with anyone like this. This is why I'm asking.
Well, what do you mean? Well, obviously, you've seen it before. You've seen an uncircumcised guy somehow come out of a tanning booth.
Yeah, I have. But I'm wondering, when they go tanning, a lot of guys go tanning. A lot of guys pluck their eyebrows, too. Same thing.
Doesn't make it okay.
No, it doesn't make it okay.
Yeah.
But when they go tanning.
These kind of guys.
The Loobies is on fire.
Exactly my point. But I'm talking about when the guy has like a George Hamilton tan and he goes to whip it out. Is it like a lightsaber?
No.
I think that's a ridiculous thought. Like
she's wondering why people don't tan the tip of their penises.
I know.
It doesn't tan. It doesn't. You can't tan purple.
I feel like you could get burnt.
You can't tan purple.
No, I know.
Yeah. But
I'm just putting on some lotion on it just to make sure I don't get burned.
I swear it's lotion.
Yeah.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Wake up.
Mornings.
Wake up.
On the Edge.
Time for some awkward female questions, and we've got Natalie on line 5. Good morning, Natalie.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Good. What's the word?
What's the word? Okay. I'm young. I have a son. I'm a single parent, and there's nobody out there that is willing to take on the challenge of a single parent.
Is that how you're trying to pick guys up?
No, not at all. Normally,
I need a daddy.
Yeah. Yeah. Are you willing to take on this challenge?
No, I honestly, I don't let them know until maybe third or fourth date. And then as soon as I do know, they let them know, it's like they're gone.
It's because you didn't let them know till the third or fourth date.
Hey, do they have like baby daddy dating websites?
They should.
Yeah, that'd be a good one.
They do, but all the guys on there just want to get girls pregnant, I feel like.
Well, probably.
That's hilarious.
Because it sounds like there's a whole breeding ground of chicks that like getting pregnant on that site.
Those internet websites, like, they scare me because I feel like they are pedophiles and they just want to go near little children.
How old are you?
That's creepy.
I'm 21.
Okay, you're 21. How old's your kid?
My kid's 3.
Okay, so you had a kid at 17. Where's the baby daddy?
The baby daddy, he's still around, but he's, like, super confusing. And, like, one minute he's asking me out, and then the next minute he's not asking me out.
Is he a good dad, though?
Probably not.
The fact that you're waiting this long to answer it?
I had this conversation with someone the other day where they were telling me, I left my wife, lived down on the beaches, getting divorced like you. I see my kids like once every 2 weeks. Didn't really agree with me, so I left. I wanted to grab him and throttle him right there. Bang, bang, bang. Because there are no men left. I've said this before.
His parents are really good.
It doesn't matter.
His parents are good.
His parents didn't impregnate you.
Yeah. And if they did, that'd be weird.
But there's no men. There are no guys that go out and take care of the responsibility physically and monetarily, which means taking the time out to do the job you have to do and then paying what you have to pay. And trust me, as someone that does both, it pisses me off even more than it probably pisses women off that their baby daddies are just pussies. Because they're not men. There's no men left.
And maybe you'll find, maybe in your case, you might have to date like an older dude. Not older, but like.
I do. But the thing is, I go for older guys and they live so far away and then they make me drive to go see them.
Of course they do, like, because they got you by the nuts.
Exactly.
She's got a kid.
She needs me. Yeah. I will say, though, like having dated women who are single mothers, it can be awkward.
It can be, but the thing is,
especially when they bring over those, what are those cribs they set up?
Oh, it's a playpen.
The playpen.
And the baby cries in the other room while you're going to town?
Because I was going to town one day, and she set up the crib in the other room, and the kid's crying, and I'm trying to do my business, and she's like, no, don't worry, he can cry. I'm like, no, we got to take care of him, poor kid.
He did. Todd actually wanted her to tend to the child, if you can believe that or not.
Yeah, this can wait. Yeah.
That's a true man right there.
Are you good looking?
I would say yes.
Well, maybe they bounce back
the younger they are, right?
That might be the problem. Maybe it's just not the baby thing. Maybe you're just not that good looking.
I have big boobs and a nice butt, but
how's the face?
Bigger nose, but
I like a big nose.
You can put a bag on my head. It's not that big of a deal.
This woman has standards.
Did you just say that?
Well, I don't know if you don't like it.
Put a bag on my head.
Turn the lights off.
No, that's
Flip
not the
me po- over.
You sound like you're good to go.
Yeah, it's aggravating. And like all these girls that I'm friends with, they have no standards and no morals and no responsibilities. Like I thought guys were into girls who have a good head on their shoulders. I'm in school. I'm working. Like, I know what I'm doing with my life. And
hey, apparently your friends know something about protection, though.
Yeah, actually, eh?
Hey, listen, do yourself a favor. You tend to your kid. Don't worry about the dude thing. It'll come after. But the most important thing I can tell you is the very second some guy asks you out, you make sure he knows you have a kid, because it won't scare him by the third date. Because what he's thinking is this: well, if she didn't tell me she had a kid for 4 weeks,
what else isn't she telling me?
The gonorrhea, she got the HIV. What's the deal?
Oh, no.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, you get out of here now, kid. You go run along. Erica.
Hi.
Talk to me.
So I'm getting married next week, and my question is, how long after should we wait to have a threesome without it ruining our marriage?
Honeymoon.
Chicks rule.
That night?
Yeah, 20 minutes.
If you're going to do it, you might as well get it over with.
Have you guys decided after you get married you're going to do it?
Oh, yeah, we've already done it, too. Like, that's how we hooked up.
You hooked up through a threesome?
Yeah, man.
And then you're getting married now, and you want. So you guys have had. When was your last threesome?
Last week.
No, oh, there you go. You don't have to worry
about
it.
Wait, I got to. Don't. Is she still on?
No, I didn't want to answer that question.
No, I
want
to ask.
She's been having them the whole time. She just wanted to go on the radio. That's all she wanted to do.
I wanted to ask about the wedding list. Like, are they all invited?
All the threesome
people?
Yeah,
yeah.
If they bring something. Yeah, everybody's invited.
Sweet orgy.
Sweet $100 a plate orgy. Hi, The Edge.
Hi, I have an awkward female question.
Yes, go ahead. Is this Leah?
Yes, it is.
Go ahead, Leah.
Okay, so once a fatty, always a fatty?
You mean if a female was overweight before and she lost some weight, do you guys still see her as overweight?
Or maybe they didn't know her then, and now they know her, you know, the way she is.
You have experience here.
Well, I'm actually still in the process, so I'm not dating. I'm not looking because I'm
too fat.
Yeah, exactly.
How much do you weigh?
I have lost 60 pounds.
And how much are you now?
I have another 60 to go. I'm not ashamed to talk.
No,
about
good for
that.
You.
So what are you? What's your exact weight?
Right now, 217 pounds.
Oh, you're fat.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'6".
Yeah, she's fat. I'm a foot taller than you, and I'm the same weight, so that'd be good. You have a low center of gravity.
Absolutely.
God bless you. And first of all, let me say this: let's not lose sight of what she's done. She lost 60 pounds. Let's give her a hand.
What's your vertical?
You know what? It's really good for kayaking.
Yeah, it is in rolling years.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so you lost 60 pounds, and you're worried that that a guy won't find you attractive if you lose more weight?
No, I'm worried that if he knows what I was before, that might just completely turn him off of, you know, despite who I am.
I have an example for you.
Okay.
And it's a personal one. When I started dating the lovely lady I'm dating now, I was probably, I don't know, 50 pounds more than I am now.
Really? Oh, okay.
And yes, she has said I am far better looking now and easier to, you know, walk around with.
Manhandle.
Easier to be seen in public with, which is good. But, you know, and I would say to her, you look at pictures. Why did you like that? She's like, I don't know. I just liked you. So, you know, it's more of a personality thing than anything else. But no guy wants to walk into a party with a beach ball with hair.
You never want to bring the biggest girl to the party.
Yeah. Who's your wife? Oh, the fattest one over there.
The one at the buffet.
Tons of fun right over there. Don't get your hand too close to her mouth.
No, but I like what you're. I like the way you're thinking. Maybe lose the weight and then meet a guy and delete all the old Facebook photos.
I'm too busy working on myself right now to bother.
Atta girl.
I'm gonna go into the gym right now and hit it. So.
Atta girl. Listen, at all the best to you, and as someone that has been there, good for you, and keep going because there is nothing better than you know being able to see your dink.
You know what?
Shouldn't have a dink. Shouldn't have a dink.
I don't have one.
Oh, I mean, there's nothing better than seeing your fupa.
Listen, I'm talking to you right now when I hit my goal weight before and after pick.
Do it. Are you going to have some of that hanging skin? That's the part I'm glad I don't have.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good question. I really don't know.
You just cut that stuff off with sewing scissors,
big
right?
Big time,
that,
yeah. You just go see someone in a back alley. They'll do it.
There's got to be some friggin' reality TV show that'll pay for it, isn't it?
I don't think so. I think you got to save up.
Okay.
How old are you?
Can we start a fund?
No. How old are you?
I'm really old.
How old's really old?
I'm going to be 40 in 3 weeks.
That's not really old.
No. Not at all.
You're reaching your prime.
Yeah, you're in your sex. See, now, when was the last time you had some sex?
I'm going to be a real beast, aren't I?
You're going to... You are going to kill somebody with that pootie.
I really am.
When was the last time you let someone in there?
Well, I don't want
to. Come on.
Come on.
Year?
No, you're going to lose it.
You're going to smell. You were going to kill someone with that thing.
You are nice.
Well, doesn't glue shut.
No, I don't know that. I just imagine nothing's been going on down there. It's like, you know, you shut a door and you open it up a year later and you go, mothballs, man.
I'm sure she takes care of it with a hoagie or something.
I'm totally sending before and after pictures.
Okay, do it. Listen, honest to God, I know we're having fun with you, but God bless you for doing
it.
Keep it up. Be proud of yourself.
It's a
big thing to do.
Absolutely.
Okay, we'll talk to you soon.
Thanks.
Bye-bye. Ugh, imagine being the first guy in there.
Might be awesome, man.
What are you talking
like
about?
Like new.
She's no, it's not like new. She's 40, so there's nowhere near new.
It's like a virgin.
No.
You don't think?
No, I remember one time I left a burger in the
the back of your car?
Yeah. It's like a quarter. And I was cleaning it up.
Yeah.
It was, man, that was tough. Because it was, wasn't just the odor, it was the, you know, because it was hard to peel. Right?
Well, you put it in it?
I tried. No, I just wanted to see, because it was like a brick. I'm like, I'm going to see if I can open this thing up. And once I did, wow, was I not turned on. And I just imagined, boom, that's what it would be like.
It's quite an imagination you have.
Bad, yeah, eh? Yeah.
This is the Dean Blundell Show.
We are dickhead free.
102.1, The Edge.
Mr. Joel Ward, everybody. Joel Woo-hoo! Ward, number 42. Yeah.
Thanks, fellas. Thanks.
Listen to this. Remember this? Remember?
Boston Bruins now turn it over. A 2-on-1. Knubel coming with Ward. Knubel with a chance. Backhander loose. They score! Yeah! It's over! Ward on a rebound! Good morning, good afternoon, and good night, Boston! The king is dead! There will be a new Stanley Cup champion! The Capitals are still dancing!
You know what I loved about that clip is how awesome it was, but it was the acceptance people of all races and religions had on Twitter after that.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you were a fan favorite, weren't you?
Yeah. Yeah. You know what? It was tough. People wanted me dead.
Why?
Dead.
What? Just because you scored a goal?
Yeah. I was trying to do the same thing that everybody else was doing.
Just score.
Score.
Yeah. And then you just scored.
And then I got in trouble.
Well,
because of the color of my skin.
Well, now we talked about it after it happened, all the racist Twitter stuff, and because you know in Boston, man, there's no racists there.
Oh God.
So we talked about it after. Was there any fallout? Like, did anybody phone you or say, "Hey, listen, we're sorry," or anybody get in touch with you and say, "Hey, this isn't on behalf of our fans"?
I had one phone call from an FBI agent.
What?
Really?
He was scared for me.
Was he really?
Which I had, you know, he was just asking some questions of like, how's your family doing? How's everybody doing? Are you okay? Like, did you get any weird messages? So now I'm like really freaked out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no, I was the only one that he kind of contacted me. He's just saying that they wanted to follow up on it. And I mean, it is what it is, man. Jeez, what can you do?
No, well, I, you know, lots. If you enlist the help, if the FBI are willing to help you, maybe they go whoop some ass for you.
Yeah, I mean, I have to go follow up when I get back to DC.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, just to kind of make sure, clear things over. But I mean, I told him I was fine. Like, my family is still living in the same place and all that.
we're not in the witness protection program. Yeah. Well, I guess things didn't get any better when the unfortunate incident happened in New York too, right?
Yeah, yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah, because you know that was a good moment, but there was a tough one after that, right?
Yeah.
Come on, boys, I'm the sausage fest here.
Yeah. Yeah, you're coming to Sausage Fest, eh, Wardo? I'm excited that you're coming.
Yeah, no, I'm excited. Yeah. No, but going back, yeah, the Rangers game was quite the episode.
What do? You get the high point, the low point, and then your coach played you the entire seventh game, and how awesome was that? The faith he showed in you.
You know, it was great. You know, even the next day after it happened, he just, you know, it was a hockey play. I made a mistake, and, you know, it was just a freak accident. It wasn't, you know, something I kind of temporarily don't really do, and so the guys knew that, and the coach was good, and yeah, as you say, I got a chance to play right away the next day, and you know, that was huge, and we won, and then we came up short in game 7.
So
yeah,
close.
Yeah. Yeah,
dude, doesn't matter. You still held your own. You made Toronto proud for sure.
Thanks, bro.
And now you're injured, right? You had an injury. What happened? Let's tell it, folks. This will be one of the greatest sports injuries ever. Have a listen to this.
I had a sports hernia.
Do you have sad music? Can we play sad music while you tell this story, Wardo?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, sad Please. Music. Here we go. This is a sad story from Joel Ward.
Yeah, so I had a lower body injury.
Yeah.
Basically, the first awkward moment is when I got prepped in the hospital.
What happened?
A gentleman came in. I was hoping for a female nurse, and I got a male one. With the razor saying, I'm here to prep.
Mm-hmm.
So he had to shave away, and at the same time he was shaving in that area,
yeah,
he was looking at me straight in the face, saying, how come you hockey guys are always clean shaven? Nurse, can I get a new one, please? Can I get a new nurse, please?
And by
it was
the way,
most
so
awkward
well
moment.
Yeah, yeah. Did he go like this after he said it?
Staring me right in the eye, shaving.
But you didn't? Did you shave yourself before you went in, right?
Yeah, well, I'm usually
clean it up. Yeah, yeah.
I clean myself right, up, but I mean, yeah, he still came in with the razor and just stared at me while doing it. And I tried to look over the TV inside, and
was he hot?
Oh, come on. So, I mean, that wasn't the dangerous part. Is the post-surgery part is the tough one.
So you get the sports hernia done.
Yes.
And a couple of days later, and it's boring after surgery, right?
Yeah. So
you can't do much. You got to lie around, watch TV.
No. You know what I did? I went to Queen Street, walked up to Queen Street as my daily exercise, and I got a few DVDs to, you know, hold it down and for a couple of days on bed rest.
Yep. Kind of DVDs.
A couple comedies, nothing too aggressive.
Okay. Okay.
But, you know, as being a single male laying in bed like that, you know, I figured I'd try to relieve myself a little bit. Well, sure enough, I got a nerve that kind of connects from my seeds up to my scarring that slowly prevents me from relieving myself.
All I know is I got a text from him that said it was like doing it with glass, broken glass.
Yeah, yeah. It was tough.
So you went to enjoy some time to yourself, and in the process, it started to hurt uncontrollably.
It was like a dog choker, just in like a zap, zoom.
Right around the fellas.
Oh.
And, so, and every guy loves doing that, too. So imagine that being the one thing you can do.
Yeah.
And it hurts like crazy.
You know what it's like to be on bed rest for doing nothing for 3 days?
Yeah, you're right. That's the only thing to do.
That's like the only thing I can come up with.
An old wacko.
Yeah. So, of course, I panicked, called the doc.
Yeah.
Said, listen, doc, what's going on
here? You talked to him about it?
What were the words that you used?
I was panicking. At first, I tried to beat around the bush, but I said, okay, enough is enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Doc, this is what the problem is. He's like, you just had surgery. Come on. Like, clean it up. Sit in bed. Take a few pills. And watch TV.
And for goodness sakes, don't whack off.
It's human.
It's
human.
It's part of what we do. It's who we are. If you say that to a guy, especially a guy like Wardo, it's like saying, don't breathe. Yeah. Really?
So I got a sore bag and a dirty scar. Thanks.
You should thank. Well, you showed us the scar, and it doesn't look fun. Like, it must have, did it get all swollen? And,
yeah.
And were you thinking, man, I really must have done a, I went to town.
So I immediately went to go get ice bags.
Did you?
Anything. Frozen peas, frozen meats, and I just laid there. I had, frozen like, the swelling is killing me.
Did you have to get another surgery after, or did the doc say, hey, just slow it down?
Yeah. He just slow grow up.
You okay now?
Yeah,
you showed any women the scar yet?
No, I keep it. It's tough.
Yeah,
mind-boggling right now.
No kidding. It's almost like having someone take the wheels off your car.
Right?
You can't go anywhere. Do anything.
Do anything. So I'm struggling right now, but I'm gonna bounce back, boys. Don't worry. I'll be
ready.
Oh,
you
to
will.
Go. Yeah, I'll bounce back in a hurry.
And ladies, watch out when he does.
Don't be scared. Don't be scared of this car.
Joel Ward from the Washington Capitals is our guest. So you injure yourself, and did you have to call the team and say this maybe set me back a couple of weeks?
Yeah, they contacted me just making sure I was doing all right. And
what'd you say?
Things are good. I'm moving along nice and slow. I'll get around to it, and hopefully I'll be back for training camp.
Did you tell him that? Like, hey, listen, everything was going fine until I started getting all uppity.
Yeah, my nuts are on fire. Somebody help. Please. That's pretty much the consensus. So my trainer just, he had a good laugh about it, but then I was being serious about it.
Yeah.
Make sure I was okay, and he said, obviously, ice bags and get the swelling down, some painkillers.
Well, what was the first thing you thought when you felt the pain, though, as you were trying to do some business? Was it like, oh, my God, they've screwed something up?
Yeah, like, do I have to get this removed now?
Yeah.
You need a chainsaw for that thing.
Bring in the amputation team.
Oh, God.
So you're coming to Sausage Fest. We're really excited.
Yeah, yeah. I got a little fantasy football, but I'll be back in later on during the day.
What do you mean fantasy football?
What are you talking about?
I'm a fantasy football. I got a draft in the middle of the day, so I got to be
What do you mean middle of the day? You got a fantasy football draft in the middle of the day, August 18th.
Yeah, sorry, boys.
With some friends? Is it online?
Some buddies, yeah, some family, some friends. You know, it's our annual football draft. I'll be there. Relax.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
When does the NFL season start that you're doing this already?
September.
It's a day that, you know, a bunch of my buddies are married and kids and stuff, so they got to plan it according to birthday parties.
Mm. Oh, I see.
Kids' birthday parties.
Come on.
It's the time when they can hang out. that's what happens when you get married, eh?
That's what happens.
It sucks, man. Bag. It's okay. The worst. Anyway, Joel Ward, our guest. You can follow him at @jrandallward42?
42, yeah. Hit me up.
On Twitter, and we're excited to see you at Sausage Fest. Thanks so much for coming in, dude.
Yeah, thanks for having me, guys.
Where are you going now?
Nowhere.
Ice down your marbles?
Same old, lay up in bed, watch a few DVDs. Breaking Bad is my new thing.
Oh, what a great show. Have you seen Breaking Bad? That's the dude from Malcolm in the Middle. I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
How incredible. Have you seen Breaking Bad?
I have no. My brother keeps telling me I should watch it.
Oh. Yeah.
You've seen it all? Oh, it's the best show on TV.
Great character, Saul Goodman.
Yep.
Jewish lawyer, amazing character.
Imagine that.
That's a shock.
Amazing character. Hey, listen, Wardo, great to see you, and all the best, team. We'll see you at Sausage Fest, and we'll check in hopefully before you take off again.
Definitely. Thanks.
Joel Ward, everybody.
Yeah. The man.
Time for a big announcement. We got a big, give me a drum roll, big concert announcement.
It's like a week of announcements.
Oh,
huh?
Dude, this is so awesome. We've been playing commercials, so it's not that big of a surprise.
Oh, we're already playing the commercials for it?
Yeah. Yeah, totally. Where'd it go?
You don't even know it?
It was right here. I just had it. It's gone.
What do you mean?
I got it right here. Where is it? Oh, I got it.
I think I have it.
Ladies and gentlemen, 102.1 The Edge presents Public Enemy, happening Sunday, September 2nd at Sound Academy. Yeah! Last year's...
Sweet, man.
Yeah, Sausage Fest headliner. But this one's different. It's really cool, and I'd love... I'm going. This is one of those shows I wouldn't miss. Tickets for the show go on sale Friday, August 10th. Ah, it's this Friday. 10 a.m. And the Dean Blundell Public Enemy presale runs Wednesday, August 8th. That is today, starting in 10 minutes. So if you want to go, you can say, I'm in for the Dean Blundell Public Enemy presale Wednesday, August 8th, 10 a.m., Thursday, August 9th at 10 p.m. That's when it ends. So it starts at 10 a.m. this morning, ends at 10 p.m. tomorrow. Stay tuned to us this week to win Beat the Boss box office tickets from the show from your club and concert station, 102.1 The Edge. We'll start giving away those tickets tomorrow. But they're going to play, I believe they're just playing one album cover to cover.
Oh, I love when they do that. So, like, okay.
Yeah. Like, it takes a nation cover to cover,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
And I couldn't be
so
more.
So it's like full on old school, legit. Yeah.
And how Wardo was here. Joel Ward's still here. You saw him last year and at Sausage Fest. Turn on his mic. How awesome was that?
Epic.
Was that one of the best shows you've ever seen?
Man, it was unbelievable. I was just staring at him.
Were you really?
Yeah, it was unbelievable for him. It's Chuck D. Like, he was just still getting up on stage, and he can just do it all.
Just going for it. Well, like, it was almost like they were 18 or 19.
That's like everyone was shocked, because he kind of, like, you were like a little worried, like, oh, they're older guys. No, yeah. they just brought it.
They brought the pain.
Yeah, and if anybody in this room knows something about pain, it's Wardo after his groin surgery, and he tried to rub one out, and he almost killed himself.
Hey, or it could be these guys.
Who's that?
These guys?
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh my god, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh my god,
the
no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's full... No, it's this place.
Isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday's.
Oh my god, you can feel the heat.
Man, that's yesterday's. I was freaking out because I was like...
Oh my god. And it's raining. And it's raining.
Sure, when it rains. But yeah, Public Enemy is going to be Sound Academy September 2nd. The morning show presale, the Dean Blundell show Inside Edge presale goes starting at 10 a.m. So in like 10 minutes, you can get tickets for everybody else. So make sure you tell your friends the presale starts at 10 a.m. this morning. And you can you go and see them do the entire album. This is why it's cool. They're going to perform It Takes a Nation of Millions to Hold Us Back in its entirety live. September 22nd, Sound Academy tickets on sale for everybody else, Friday, 10 a.m. But make sure you get your tickets starting in 10 minutes for the Public Enemy show. Very excited for that.
Beauty.
Yeah.
Do we get is Taggart around, or do we not get in touch with him?
We should probably call him.
Try him, yeah.
Hang on a second.
good prep right here.
Good voodoo on. We're on the air, dude.
Wardle. Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Voodoo's emailing you? Voodoo porn stars
He's
emailing
like, get voodoo on. No, we had a great night one night with, we went to the underground with Wardle and voodoo and stuff, yeah. And I'd say there were a lot of shots going on that night, but.
What a dude.
Yeah, voodoo's a classic.
Is he a beauty
He's
or what?
He's fun to party with.
Is he?
And chicks just were so excited to meet him.
I would have thought chicks would have just washed themselves immediately after. You were excited to meet him?
Of course.
Why? Because he's a legendary porn star?
Yeah, I just admire his story, man. When I first heard it, I was like, when's this guy coming back on the air?
He removed.
Yeah, I was.
You heard him on the air?
Yeah. My favorite show.
What? When he was on?
Yeah, when he was on.
Was it really?
Telling us the stories of the skydiving and his dad being the TTC driver and stuff. We'll get him on. I think he's in Vegas right now.
Is he really?
Of course.
Rightfully so.
Yeah.
I heard you can't get an STD in Vegas.
That's true. Oh. Cool.
Oh, I can't get a hold of Tagger.
Oh, come on.
There's no point. I can't get a hold of him. His phone hasn't worked all morning. Hi, The Edge. Hey.
How are you doing?
Good. Who's this?
Hey. Who do you think it is?
Cyrus.
Hey, Cyrus, we had a clip of you and your buddies driving around this morning. That house fire. Did you hear this?
You hear that?
Did you post this? Let's have a listen. This is crazy. There's a fire. These guys.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant
is... Oh, my God. No, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God.
The
no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's... No. It's this place.
Is that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday.
Oh, my...
Is that you?
Yeah, that's me. You got me.
Yeah.
It totally sounds like you, man.
So a good vacation?
Yeah.
Yeah. You have a joke?
Well, I want to tell you about my vacation, actually, because you know what? I went out and I got 2 TVs. I know it's kind of crazy, but...
Cyrus, can you assure me that this punchline is good?
Yes.
You can assure me, without question, that this punchline is going to be something I would like to hear.
Absolutely.
So you got 2 TVs.
So I got 2 TVs, and you know what? They got along really well, and they ended up getting married. And I went to the wedding, and it was okay, but the reception was amazing.
Oh, God.
Yeah, the Loobies is on fire.
Reception.
I get it. TVs. Yep.
Are you sure about that?
I'm very sure about that. It's the stupidest joke I ever heard in my life.
Well, you know, I'm trying. Have a good day, boys.
See you, bud. Okay. The Loobies was on fire. This is a clip that, if you're wondering where this came from, this clip came from these 3 men driving around. Loobies was a bar that caters to men, and they used to frequent it, and it caught fire.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant
is... Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God,
the
no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's it's this place.
Is that yesterday?
That's not yesterday.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
Yeah. Hi, The Edge. Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
Not much. Just wanted to say welcome back to the boys.
Oh, thanks dude. Sir.
Yeah.
That was it?
Yeah, Todd's gay.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, what's going on, bro?
Good, who's this?
My name is Robbie.
What's up? Oh, how old are you?
35.
Yeah, it's Rob, I think, after 25. Okay. Well, you can go, Robbie.
Listen, I'm just curious. I won last night at 3 o'clock in the morning the 2 sets of tickets for Penn and Norman or something like that. And,
yeah, Paranorman.
And the left pocket or something like that.
Yeah.
I was just curious to know. I'm just at an appointment right now, but can I cruise down today to pick up the tickets?
Yeah.
Thanks for wasting everybody's time.
Jesus Christ.
I can't believe you won't let that one go on as long as you did.
I don't know
what
I'm
thinking.
What
do you think he was
going to
say?
I'm getting soft.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, hi, The Edge.
Hey, what's going on, boys?
How are you?
I love how the one guy almost sounds like he's crying when he's like, bar and grill? Yesterday's bar and grill?
Well, it was where the Loobies is, I've been told, is a bar that caters to men and other men that like to be around other men.
You got my email?
Yeah. Todd's been there several times. And listening to the guys talk, if you listen to this clip, there's a couple things. A, the guys are dumb because they can't believe a fire can happen while it's raining. B, these guys were there the day before in a daisy chain for sure. Do you have the audio there? Have a listen.
The Loobies is on fire.
Girl, that restaurant is...
Oh, my God, no, that's yesterday's.
Oh, my God,
the
no.
The bar and grill.
The bar.
It's full... No, no, it's this place.
Bar and grill.
That's, isn't that yesterday's?
That's not yesterday's.
Oh, my God, you can feel the heat.
Man, that's yesterday's. I was freaking out because I was like...
Oh, my God. And it's raining. And it's raining.
Get some pictures.
Yeah, get some pictures.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, you guys see that Olympic handball yesterday?
No.
Oh, my God.
What happened?
Handball. It was handball in the Olympics. It was women's handball. It was the most ridiculous sport I'd ever seen in my life.
Yeah, again, we've been seeing it all morning. There's real athletes. Yeah, there's real athletes, and there's ones who fail at the real sports.
Like Wardo. You made it to the NHL. Joel Ward made it to the NHL. Had you not been a very good hockey player when you were younger, you would have been an Olympian, because that's what they do. They go, okay. It was like your dad. He would say to you, hey, Joel, you had a tough game today. Might want to consider shot put.
Oh, my God,
oh yeah. Joe Wardo, you sat on the bench most of the game this morning, and you Pee-wee, have you thought about air rifle?
Oh, man. Yeah, you got to look out for Olympic handball. It was amazing.
Oh, you liked it?
Oh, brutal, brutal.
Yeah, it's intense. The handball. One thing I did watch, which I actually didn't mind, was women's water polo. And when I say I watched, how intense was it? Did you watch that yesterday?
Oh, my God.
They beat the hell out of each other.
Oh, they had that shot, like that shot to get it with 1 second left to go into overtime. Did you see that one?
Yeah, with the Australia.
Yeah, that was stupid.
Who won? Did that really happen?
Yeah, it did happen.
Who won? Do you know who won?
The States won.
They won?
In OT.
Oh, you're kidding.
Yeah, I know.
But you know what they do in women's water polo? They like drown each other. Yeah. And then they hit each other right in the titties. Like they do. Like before they get the ball, they drive into each other's chests and then they back off.
Well, that's why I was kind of impressed with women's soccer, because they get a little bit testy. Oh. And I just wish the guys could have some.
I'm pretty sure some of the chicks did. That Abby Wambach is one tough dude.
But
yeah, that's all it is. If you became an Olympian, it means you are not very good at regular sports, because you can't tell me some dad went after his like basketball game, his kid didn't play. He's like he threw up bricks the whole game, and he's like in 15. He's like, I'm suck at basketball. And he's like, gently steer you into canoeing.
You'd be the dude shouting direction in the kayak.
Yeah.
You're in the rower.
You'd be a great coxswain.
Come on, guys. Let's go. Let's go.
So, thank God you're good at hockey, Joel.
Yeah, thanks.
Because you would have been competing in mixed trampolining.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, I know, eh?
We don't have that in Scarborough.
Yeah, they do.
We don't have that in Scarborough.
Trampolines?
No. No. Not competitive.
Okay.
Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.